a 2001 Carver 444 that is new to the market in Southern California. This particular vessel is kept here at the Chula Vista Marina in San Diego. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has.
Right, so here we are looking at the Carver 444, and we're starting out the bow. As you can see, it has a really robust anchor on it. This is an anchor that will definitely set in any type of conditions, and you can definitely sleep at night. Electric windlass. We also have foot up and down switches here. Up at the bow, we have a spotlight, and then as you can see, this beautiful lounge area. But I'll walk you up there so you can see that. The vessel was just buffed and waxed, and it is in amazing condition for its age. What I really like is the large windows, just flooding that salon with natural light. There's gonna be lots of opening hatches as well, so you can get that airflow. And then here's another trick thing. So these are side boarding entryways. So if you have dock steps, you have easy access from up here on this deck down, and or you have access from the aft deck as well too. Really impressive. I love just like, you know, the inlets for the dock lines, fenders to hold off of. They've really done a great job. So here at the transom, you can see we have a nice large swim platform area. We also have a nice system here that allows the dinghy to be brought up on the transom and stowed while underway. Nice little lightweight center console Achilles dinghy. I like what they've done here to keep the weight down. They create this nice stainless bracket with the wheel on it. This is a 18 horsepower Nissan dinghy. Swim step boarding ladder is off to the starboard side of the vessel. All right, so coming in, we have this really nice entry gate that opens up and allows us into the aft cockpit. The aft cockpit has a couple different things here. We have large storage below here. This houses accessibility to the steering shaft quadrants, additional storage here, a large Cuisinart barbecue, and then you also have steps off to the starboard side as well too. So depending on how you're gaining access and or availability to the dock. This is also really impressive. So this is access right into the aft master cabin. Gives you kind of that open feel and allows, again, lots of ventilation to blow through the boat. We have a swim step shower located here, and then the inlets for the electrical receptacles for shore power. As we walk up, I notice these large stainless steel handhelds getting us up into this upper deck. Now, when we come into the upper deck, you can see that it's fully enclosed with isinglass, and also has carpet in here as well. But this is a great aft deck, or aft upper deck, I should say, when we have the aft lower deck below us, to kind of get up here out of the weather and also have really phenomenal views. So if you're sitting out in Catalina Island and you just want to kind of get out of the elements, you have the hard top above you here, and you could do so. You also have accessibility from both starboard and port side to, you know, gain access to the foredeck. This is the kind of the boarding entryway that I was talking about earlier. We also have our diesel, our waste fill and pump out. Nice stainless steel handles here. So as we walk up to the forward deck, you really feel secure. This entryway is quite perfect, you know, to walk up. So it's not wasting any space, but it is easy to walk up and gain access to this lovely bow area. So up here we have, again, the you know, bow cushions. You can come up here, you can lounge, you can relax. We have accessibility to the overhead hatch for the V-berth. And then we have our anchor locker here. So inside the anchor locker, pretty straightforward. This just opens up and gives us accessibility down here. You can also see there is a spigot for a washdown as well. But great easy access here. And again, I like these chafe protectors, and really done a nice job with this forward bow section. As we look aft, again, you can see how that stainless steel rail has been carried all the way around. So aesthetically, it's quite pleasing. And again, it gives you that security as you're walking around the vessel. You just really always have a good handhold everywhere you go. Now we're gonna be coming back into it, the aft upper deck. And again, nice entry door that can close off so it can block all the wind while underway or just to get out of the elements. And then we have a great area here. There's a flat screen Samsung television. We have just storage and accessibility here for just random things. And then we're gonna be walking up to the upper flybridge. So here on the upper flybridge, again, nice handhold here, easy steps that are carpeted. We have our nice little storage locker here, cup holder, 110 outlet, our sink, and then right here is a nice little ice maker. And again, there's a portable ice maker above here. So this is a large upper flybridge. We have this huge, you know, kind of L-shaped seating here. And then here at the helm, we have great accessibility to a lot of different things. So somebody can sit here. We have access to a stereo unit, cup holders. We have the Raymarine ST60 depth, the RL70C plotter, and then our AIS. This is our standard horizon VHF. So here at the helm, you can see that, you know, you have really good visual of all your instrumentation, our throttle controls. And I like that we have our throttle and our transmission controls all in one here. But look at this visibility when you're sitting down. So great visibility all the way around. And you really feel like, you know, you're part of the group when you're up here. You're not so isolated as like a true flybridge. The engines have about 1900 hours on them. The generator has about 1400 on them. You have all your ship's, you know, control switches here. This is a Garmin. This is a 3210 GPS map plotter. And then we have our Simrad autopilot. Searchlight controls there, stereo speakers, and then a nice side starboard helm seat. So again, really nice layout, great visual. And again, for the age, the boat's in really good condition. All right, so let's work our way back down to the upper aft deck. And then we are gonna go down below into the salon. So the salon has this really nice, easy sliding companionway door that allows us in here. So we have virtually four steps coming into the salon. And again, this is a beautiful vessel, just really nice and open. If you're looking for a cruising boat or a liveaboard, I mean, this will hit all elements. So the salon is set up in a couple of different parts. We have, you know, bench seating off to the port side here. We have our instrumentation breakers and all of our electrical breakers behind this panel. So this allows us to transfer over to ship to shore. We have a Freedom battery monitor here, and then all of our breakers and so forth. Just above that is additional breaker system. So this is all of our main DC controls. So this is all, you know, our water pressure pumps, bilge pumps, lights, what have you. So that's set up here. And then just above that is Kenwood CD changers. Pretty nice. So Vizio flat screen television, forehead, hi-fi, VHS, if I'm saying that right, it's been a while. And then we have our Kenwood stereo control there. But again, lots of storage around here. It's really beautifully done, you know, beautiful kind of tan, you know, leather seating. We have these side ports that actually open up, and they have mini blinds that kind of give you privacy there. And then shades over these upper windows. So nice kind of a coffee table here. Just below this section right here is access to our engine room, and all three panels do open up to provide great accessibility to the engines. We have this large, huge sofa off to the starboard side. This also can be made into a bed, so it's a really nice setup here, and it just gives you a real open feel. So lots of versatility that you can do here. Again, look at these windows. They are just really impressive, just how you feel. You come down below, but you still have all of the visual to look out, to be able to see the water and really experience that. So here we have kind of a cabinet nook with a storage. Again, you can see just this really neat design that they have, these beautiful Corian countertops. And then now we're looking at kind of our semi-down galley. We have a stainless steel sink here with a faucet, microwave, kind of a toaster oven, coffee maker, a three burner electric princess stove, lots of storage and cabinets below that. And I really like this little touch that they did here with the, kind of the faux tile. And again, just lots of neat little clever spaces here. and again, how they carry this trim work out. So if you do have stuff stored up here, you have these fiddles, you know, to kind of keep that stowed. NovaCool fridge and freezer compartment. So this is quite large as well. And then you have the faux teak and holly flooring here. And then again, more additional storage. So I'm gonna take you to the forward VIP cabin. The VIP cabin is situated quite nicely. Easy accessibility to both starboard and port side of the bed, so you can easily make the bed. And then we have off to the starboard side, the head compartment. What I like about this is they really separated it. So you have the vacuum flush toilets, large countertop space, lots of storage around. And again, just a great design. And directly across from us is our shower compartment. So cleverly done, you know, what a way to utilize the space. But we have a full, you know, separate shower on this side with a bench seat, your faucet, and additional storage for towels and what have you there. But again, looking up here at this cabin, this really nice bed, we have a hanging locker closet here, 110 outlets, our air conditioning, heating controls. There are three opening ports. So again, ventilation is really designed well on this boat. Normally you just don't have that, so ventilation is kind of tight, so you need to be running your air all the time, but here you don't. You can crack open the windows and get that airflow. But again, another 110 outlet on that side, these Corian countertops, how they're laid in, opening ports, and again, all of this material seems to be in really good condition with beautiful carpeting in here as well. This is a pocket door, so you can see with just this clip opens up, so the pocket door, you know, saves space, but also really gives you that privacy that you're looking for as well. All right, so let's make our way back. We have incredible headroom here. Also, I want to point out, I've turned the lights off, but I want to point out that these are LED interior lighting, so you're really going to save on that energy consumption there. As we work our way to the master cabin, behind here you have our air conditioning, heating controls, and more, you know, storage throughout, additional countertop space with 110 12 volt outlets, and yeah, very well designed. All right, so coming into the aft master cabin, light switches are located right here. We have two steps down, we have a large hanging locker closet here, but take a look at this you know, cabin. It's really impressive. You know, this orientation of the bed is quite nice. And it gives you accessibility on both sides. Lots of storage and shelving throughout here. Again, this Corian countertop space that they've wrapped around. So you have nightstands. You have two opening hatches here. This amazing aft door that just opens up, you know, into that lower aft deck. Additional hanging locker closet there. Vizio flat screen television. And then from here, we walk into our head and shower compartment. So here we have very similar. It is the vacuum flush toilet, large countertop space here. This is also a really neat feature here that I won't kind of go into right now, but it's a sanitation system that was put into this head. So really impressive, but you can look that company up. We also have large sliding mirrors here, two opening hatches, and take a look at this full, you know, walk-in shower. There's a little lock up here, but this walk-in shower is quite nice. Lots of room, full bench seat here. You know, you have a little hanging spot here and then your shower faucet. So good use of space. Very, very innovative for its design, and just a really incredible and very comfortable aft cabin. We also have speakers there by your head, carbon monoxide, fire detection, air conditioning, heating controls here. And then nice, easy steps making our way up into the aft lower deck, where if you choose to, this slip could potentially be transferable. And look at the view you have looking out. That's Coronado Island and then the Pacific Ocean right there. Well, I just want to thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 2001 Carver 444, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hopefully earning your business and answering all the questions that you might have and getting you on board this boat. Thank you again. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and see, you know, what's coming on the market before it even hits the MLS. Thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you.